My name is Dr. Austin Gallagher. I'm a marine biologist, and I've been studying sharks in the Caribbean region for the last decade. I've been working in the Bahamas for a long time and have really seen the benefits of big marine protected areas for conserving sharks over long time periods. Sharks are really slow growing and very threatened group of animals, so these protected areas are really critical. And we saw this was working so well in the Bahamas, we knew we had to start expanding to other places in the Caribbean, trying to find ways to plug this model into new countries that were maybe interested or really had a need to conserve sharks. And that's what brought us to Turks and Caicos. We were really fortunate to be invited down here by the government and some of the other local stakeholders to really begin surveying shark and ray populations here to get a baseline establishing measure of what this ecosystem looks like so that we can actually support proposed legislation and policy that will create a protected area for these animals here in Turks and Caicos. Turks and Caicos and the Bahamas share a general area in our ocean called the Lucayan Archipelago. And this is a really interesting geological ocean feature because it's basically these shallow carbonate banks that have formed over many, many thousands of years in ice ages. And what it's done, it's created these really interesting diverse habitats. Very similarly to what we see in the Bahamas, we have shallow seagrass banks that all of a sudden drop off into really, really deep oceans. What it does is it creates so much space for these animals to live, whether we're talking about reef sharks that have their favorite coral reef, or even tiger sharks, which during the day prefer shallow seagrass beds, and then at night will go into these really, really deep areas in the tongue of the ocean, or here, it's a steep cliff where it drops off into the twilight zone. Our first research expedition actually occurred during peak COVID in 2020. And because of that, we knew we had to go with a small team. So in this first expedition, it was just Sammy and myself.
My name is Sammy Catan. I'm the director of digital media at Beneath the Waves. I was really excited to head down to the Turks and Caicos because prior to doing our work in the Bahamas, we'd gone to a lot of areas that were overfished, and frankly, it was really difficult to find sharks. So I had a good feeling that the Turks would provide an incredible diversity of animals as it's a continuation of the Bahamas chain and has that proximity to the Atlantic Ocean.
Jumping on a plane, last minute, going down. We'd been planning the trip for a long time, back and forth with travel restrictions and COVID regulations, testing, are we gonna be able to get it done? So we just decided to come down, just the two of us.
All right, well, we are here in the Turks and Caicos. Let's check out these waters. Oh. New territory.
And we were really, really fortunate to link up with Mark and Phil from Big Blue Collective, who have become incredible supporters and also research assistants for us here.
My name is Mark Parrish. I'm one of the owners of Big Blue Collective. We do a lot of work with the local Department of Environment and Coastal Resources, so they know that we're always willing to work with visiting groups and visiting scientists. You know, that's one of the reasons we set up the platform, was to do that. You know, it's a part of our own interest and our own curiosities. From one side to the other, you know, it's taken me 20 years to really explore and get to know the island really intimately, and I'm still learning. It's an easy place to fall in love with. It's such an incredible environment, but it's so diverse, and there's so much to explore. We love hooking up with researchers. They always have a wealth of information. They always bring great toys with them, or these instruments that we can use to study and learn that much more.
It's always really exciting when you go to do research in a new place for the first time, looking for sharks where really no one else has looked before. Sharks are very elusive predators, so you need to entice them to come close to you, no matter what type of research you're doing. For our first few expeditions here in Turks and Caicos, we knew that we wanted to take a non-invasive approach to doing that, and it involved using these tools called baited remote underwater videos, which is essentially a great way to spy on these animals without ever having to touch an animal. You have a camera that's looking right out into the ecosystem with a little bit of bait that attracts sharks to the camera. In addition to our bruvs, we've also been utilizing cutting-edge molecular techniques, specifically a tool called environmental DNA, also known as eDNA. We're able to sample the water in which all these animals live in and capture any DNA that might be free-flowing in that water sample. We eventually bring that back to the lab and we can sequence that water sample and see who's been there. That first trip was awesome because we had no idea what we were gonna see. And I remember reviewing the footage from the first few bruvs that we put out and seeing that little small reef shark come right up to the frame. And at that point we knew that there was at least something here to get really excited about. I was not prepared for the diversity and abundance of shark and ray species that we saw. Everything from reef sharks to lemons, nurses, and dozens of blacknose, sometimes at once in one frame, were seen throughout the reefs here in our first couple surveys. What was also really exciting is to see what we think is a pretty healthy ray population as well. Whether it's schools of eagle rays passing through, or even we were so lucky to see an oceanic manta ray over on West Caicos. We got incredible drone footage of it. So there really is something to be said about the conservation for these animals here because there is a good baseline here. Our driving goal is to eventually support the proposed legislation to create a nationwide marine protected area for sharks and rays here in Turks and Caicos. But in addition to that, we're going to create so much knowledge that we're really going to put shark research and sharks more broadly on the map for Turks and Caicos and really start to galvanize the movement around shark conservation in the Caribbean. After our first expedition, we were able to sit down with members of the government, specifically the Department of Environment and Coastal Resources, and show them some of our data. It's really exciting too when all of your data is video-based so you can actually make it seem like a nature documentary. And really, you can see people's eyes open up. Wow, they have so many cool things here in our ecosystem. And really what that did was pave the way for future expeditions. Just 3 weeks later, we were back down here with a new team with the same mission to continue our survey and expanding to other areas. Sammy was able to lead the second expedition and brought Jamie as well as Alyssa and Hanan down for that trip. So we essentially doubled our workforce and we were able to sample a rather remote part of the Caicos Islands, specifically on the south side. Again, trying to expand as much survey coverage as we could in just a 3 to 5 day trip.
Headed back on the second trip to the Turks and Caicos, I was really excited to expand our survey and research and see what else we would find in the Big Blue. And lo and behold, 2 days into our research, we were not disappointed when off East Caicos in the channel, we found two turtles mating. So of course, we had to get in what ended up being a pretty romantic experience.
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wondering in the night, what were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through.
Wow. In all their years, Mark, Philip, and the whole BBC team had never seen anything like that, which continued this theme that the Turks and Caicos hosts an incredible amount of pelagic life and you truly never know what you're gonna see when you go out on the boat.
After sitting down and reviewing all the data from the first few trips, we realized there was a real opportunity to, again, expand our work. We wanted to continue the bruvs, but there also was a chance to start bringing in some other elements of the Beneath the Waves research suite, such as shark tagging, and of course, our deep sea research program. I was really surprised that we had not seen a tiger shark yet on the first few bruvs. Maybe it was a seasonal thing, not exactly sure. So on this trip, we wanted to try and make sure to capture those animals as much as possible. And really, we've learned that's all about finding the right habitats. Tiger sharks in particular are really, really successful on shallow sandbanks. So we started talking to Mark and Phil to find where those locations could be, and we found exactly where that was. It's time to go deep.
I got it. Great. 11 o'clock, right over there. See you.